So, Kieran, obviously you signed with the club a couple of weeks ago. You're now into pre-season. How's things going?
It's been brilliant. Obviously started back last week, and since then it's been a lot of running, a lot of tough sessions, but that's what we expect in pre-season, and now we're down at Largs and hopefully we'll see more of the ball and we'll get to do a lot more functional stuff.
And you studied at Duke, but let's go back way before that. You were at Celtic as an academy player. How was that?
Started off at Celtic 8, 9 years old, worked my way all up the academy, and then was offered a professional contract at 16, which was my dream come true. But then I chose to stay on, do a fifth year in high school to get my hires, and then I was offered the same professional contract at 17 again, but after doing so well at school, I chose to pursue a scholarship in America.
And then that scholarship in America, you went to Duke University. You studied politics, which is obviously great to have I presume that was a backup option in your mind?
Yeah, I think kind of doing school and football was working so well for me. I was doing it at Celtic with the school project there, the St. Ninian, so I was studying and playing for Celtic, and it was working well. I was doing well at school and doing well at football, and I just thought, why not kind of keep up that balance? And I thought America was the best place to go and do that. And obviously football being so unpredictable and the career lasting relatively pretty short, I thought it was good to have something as a backup to present more opportunities when I finished playing football.
And over there you met Marcus Fjortoft.
Yes.
I believe he kind of showed you about the place when you first came, is that right?
Before I made the decision to go to America, me and my dad went and visited the university, and he was my host, so he hosted me all weekend. I stayed at his place, and then I decided to go, and I spent 3 years with him, playing with him, so yeah, we're pretty close friends now.
So does that seem a bit surreal now that yous are both playing for a Scottish Premiership side together?
It's mental, you never would have thought it, and I was saying to him, it was actually my first away trip in America. We were roommates, and now we're at Largs for Hamilton, and we're roommates, and it's just mental how it's came back full circle.
So obviously when you came back to America, you were at Falkirk, you had a spell there. You know, that gave you the taste back into Scottish football as a senior player at championship level.
Aye.
What's the ambitions now? You're in the Premiership, you know, you could potentially be bonding a good partnership with Marcus.
Mm-hmm.
And what's
I think coming back from America, the main goal was to get into real football as quickly as I could. Obviously, playing academy and playing in America, I hadn't really experienced real professional football, and so the goal was to get into that at a good level, and Falkirk gave me that opportunity, and I learned a lot there. And then after that experience ended, it was looking at, I'm still young, I've only experienced 6 months of professional football, and so I still need to develop and learn, and where is the best place to do that. And obviously with the manager being here, he's kind of known for his coaching and developing young players, and I thought that's why this was the best place to come. So I'm just really excited. I'm excited to obviously be at a Premiership club and all the experiences that brings and the challenges and playing against the best players in Scotland and also learning from a lot of experienced players and from the manager.
Talk to me a little bit about Brian Rice. So how is he with you? Obviously, you just said that he was obviously a factor in coming to the club.
Well, I think I met with him a few times before signing for the club, and I think it was very obvious how enthusiastic and committed it was to developing players. And obviously this is his first time as a manager, and so he's been a coach most of his career, and I think you can see that. And he's passionate to develop players and to coach players. It's probably the first thing you notice, and like I said, me being a young player, that's exactly what I need, a manager who's enthusiastic and wants to play young players and develop them.
How will it be for yourself going back to Celtic on the 14th of September?
I mean, growing up, I've no lies, I was a Celtic fan, and it was always my dream to play for Celtic, and so it was always a dream to play at Celtic Park. Now that I'll be doing that maybe under different circumstances, so I'll just be excited for the experience.
So we've got obviously Celtic at home on the 14th of September, we then play them away at 4th of December.
Mm-hmm.
So Celtic Park, I said, that'll be one of the ones to tick off your list then, yeah?
Aye, hopefully. But we'll just take it one step at a time, obviously a lot to get in before that.
Course. And just lastly, I need to ask you are a young football player, you are going to just get your career going again at a senior level, but your ambitions after football most football players would be management. Is yours politics and getting into potentially?
I think so. I think I've always been pretty enthusiastic about politics. I think it was the independence referendum that did that back in 2014. And ever since then, I've just really took an interest in it. And that's why I studied it in America. So I still try and keep as engaged as possible in it. And that would be definitely something open to me after football, I think.